as chefs, we're always trying to push people to try new things. It was always a treat for me to sneak eel onto a menu where it's now accepted to do something a little bit funky, a little bit weird.
When you have an idea, or any of my chefs have a desire to do something, we do it by committee, but we also have a lot of liberty in allowing the progressions to take place.
We're never relegated or imprisoned by any style of food.
And that's what creativity is, right? It is always changing.
Always changing, always looking ahead, and hopefully the customers come with you in that journey.
A dish is always a work in progress until the day it goes off the menu.
This is something that I used to do here long distance before your time, when you were still a diaper.
Oh, gotcha.
This is an eel terrine, and it was one way for me to introduce eel. We'd put things that were familiar in it, so it'd be like peppers, asparagus, obviously eel, and then we'd make a green apple gelée, basically. We'll get some asparagus going. To be quite honest, I don't really even remember this dish, but this is close to what it was. We're supposed to write down, aren't we?
Not necessarily.
I do remember we did pistachio oil. I used to plate everything in like in circles like this. Everything had to be very symmetrical.
A lot of what I do now is just kind of a rejection of things that I was taught. The most important thing I remember was consistency, consistency, consistency.
I just remembered the creme fraiche.
That when you create a dish, you're creating it for that customer to come in and have it the same every single time.
Green apple and caviar, beautiful pairing. Just that salt and the tart. Finish it off with sea salt. I think we added a little bit of sweet vinegar.
Now, there's a beauty in that. There's certain foods or certain restaurants or certain outposts that you always want to be the same. But I'm not one of them.
So that is a eel terrine. That's my dish. Now your turn.
All right. I was challenged with the evolution of a dish, and so I decided to make a croquette. Take eel, we added some egg, flour, mashed potatoes, made a little paste out of it. We're gonna flour, egg wash, and panko this.
You don't wanna be an old curmudgeon-y restaurant that just says, oh, I only do it the old school way. But you also don't wanna be the guy that's chasing every new trend just because it's new. That's a difficult balance to strike. Helps having young people in your kitchen because they always are constantly throwing new ideas at you.
Here we have a little bit of celery root puree.
Celery root on that?
Yep.
That's disgusting.
Really?
Yeah.
That sort of butting heads will always happen, and it's a good thing. That's where some of the best things come out, is that you know, clash.
So the selling point here is really the lobster and peas. Pea tendrils. A little lemon, a little olive oil.
Yeah.
Finish with just a touch of the Maldon sea salt. Eel croquettes.
The one thing we haven't done with eel is, here's the eel.
Yeah.
What we do changes because nature is not static either.
I've never put eel and octopus together. I know it's gonna work. They come from the same nebulous place. They're both kind of in the margins.
The farms, agriculture, is always in motion. The beets are ready, the corn isn't. It never just stops.
Can we get creative? Let's do this.
You know what would be cool is to have ingredients coming off the top. And
that's exactly what I had in mind, too.
See, we do think alike sometimes.
It's crazy, isn't it?
I started thinking about the motion and the movement that happens. I said it's very natural to adjust the items on the menu in small ways as the harvest adjusts.
If we take the florets off.
This is when I really like you. I was literally doing the exact same thing with my hand that you were doing on the board. Octopus, I want to do some chili thread. This reminds me of barbecue, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
And I can't have barbecue without some kind of pickle. I think that would be an excellent garnish. Pickled green strawberries are really cool.
How about a little charred grilled eggplant?
Just a touch.
We have some nice wood sorrel. This will offer a really nice lemony kind of feel to it.
I'm with you.
That sense of movement, that sense of constant changing, it's something that I want to reflect on the menu.
People are starting to get it. There is this incredible palette, this panoramic landscape of cuisine, and we don't have to be relegated to just eating chicken, beef, and fish.